developed a 3D scanning tool we called Pictus Metric tool. And it was to address a problem with patients not complying with using the treatment options to correct both pectus excavatum and pectus carinatum.
Pectus excavatum, where the chest goes in, and pectus carinatum, where the chest comes out. So where the chest goes in, we put a suction cup on to pull it up, and where the chest goes out, we put a brace on to push it back in. But those treatments take place over a year or 2 years, which for a teenager is very slow progress.
The methods that they have is just really a ruler put on the chest, and that's not very accurate, and plus you're pushing on the skin, and so very error prone and not very informative.
Dr. McKenzie developed a scanner that enables us to make a topographical map of the patient's chest, and they come at one visit when they start treatment and they get a scan, and then when they come back 3 months or more later, another scan can be done, and the software that his team developed will subtract one scan from the other and show the progress.
Once the two scans are aligned, we use our own algorithm to measure the difference between the pre and the post. And then after we measure the difference, we overlay the difference as a color map and show in millimeters how much improvement or changes they saw between treatments.
Which has been very helpful in encouraging patients to stay the course, to keep using the treatment, because it can be easy to be discouraged when progress is slow.
It really made me realize there's a very good possibility that I don't have to do the surgery, which was awesome.
It was a noticeable difference to see Dr. Kelly so enthusiastic about the changes in his chest was very encouraging for us.
Oh, the patients love it. The families love it, especially. It gives a very nice, colorful printout, and it gives numbers which people love to have as far as how much the progress has been or lack thereof. We've had patients who, one fellow, for example, who didn't use the vacuum bell, and over the year between intervals, he was 11 millimeters deeper, which is a considerable progression. So we were able to say, well, gee, if you're not going to do this, you probably better have surgical treatment. So it was helpful to the family to be able to say, well, look, it doesn't just look worse to you, it is worse.
Our technique not only shows the patient and parent visually the improvement, but it also gives an objective result, an objective measurement for the surgeons to see how the treatment is improving the patient.
It's one of those ideas that immediately found interest, so that a group from France developed something similar, another group from Italy developed something similar, and Dr. McKenzie has sent his scanner to the group in Seoul, Korea, who are using it in their practice. So there are a number of people that are interested in this just now.
Another hospital in Seoul, Korea, had requested one of these systems, and they have also been using it for several months now. We have a long collaboration with the Children's Hospital of the King's Daughters, especially Dr. Robert Kelly and Dr. Bob Obermeyer, and several other surgeons over there.
Dr. McKenzie's worked with us on some other efforts as well in trying to refine the brace treatment, for example, and to look at how to measure the forces involved when the chest wall is corrected. So it's been a very productive exchange.